policy advisor. He once worked at the State Department, and I know that he's going to agree with me on this. Let me start with the obvious question. Which is a bigger threat to the U.S., ISIS or Russia?
Both are a huge threat.
Which is bigger?
Well, I think ISIS is a more immediate threat, absolutely. But Russia has a much stronger military. Russia can hurt us and hurt U.S. interests all over the world. So we have to worry about both.
So let me just, we don't have the graphic because I'm just kind of going here with the facts as they are. We have on the one side ISIS, Islamic terror, Al-Qaeda. Over the past 15 years, thousands of Americans have lost their lives, many thousands, to those forces. Russia has killed, let me just see, zero Americans. So it's really not even in the same universe, actually, the threat we face from Islamic terror and the threat we face from Russia. One is theoretical, the other is real and present. So why are we not seeing that?
Well, first of all, Tucker, you can't evaluate the threat just based on how many American lives have been lost. Russia is a threat to democracy. It's a threat to our way of life. Look at what Russia has done in Ukraine. It annexed Crimea. It is in eastern Ukraine. It's killed a lot of people in Ukraine. Ukraine wanted to be part of the West. It wanted to be a democracy. It wanted to join Europe. It wanted to be our ally. Russia has been threatening democracy for a long time. Okay. Look at the Cold War.
Before we jump back 26 years, let me just get to the discrete examples that you just listed. You say they're a threat to our way of life, to our democracy. I feel for the Ukrainians. I feel for the Crimeans. I feel for anybody whose nationalist hopes are thwarted. How is the annexation of Crimea or the conflict with Ukraine a direct threat to national security?
Because if Russia is allowed to annex Ukraine, it will annex another country next. It will annex one of the Baltic states.
Idaho?
It'll annex two of the Baltic states.
California? I mean, how will that affect American national security?
Do you not believe that there are countries like Russia who have who desire to undermine democracy all over the world,
lots of them.
Particularly in Europe, and part of their strategy for doing that is undermining democratic efforts in countries like Ukraine, in the Baltic states.
I'm asking you simple questions. Just give me simple answers, if you would. How is Russia's expansionist tendencies, which are shared by a lot of countries around the world, lots of countries want to be bigger. This is the story of the world, of history. How does Russia's behavior in Eastern and Central Europe threaten America's critical national security interests or America's democracy?
Because one of the things that America has always stood for is freedom and spreading democracy around the world. And the biggest foe of freedom and the spread of democracy is Russia. And we see that now in lots of different places where Russia is an actor, particularly in Eastern Europe, where it has designs on recreating a Russian empire, on recreating colony-type states that it had when it was the USSR.
Just for the hell of it, I'm going to ask the question one more time, because you didn't answer the question I asked. You basically said Russia's behavior offends our values as Americans, and I would agree with that completely. But that's not the criterion upon which we make war decisions. We go to war, we are enemies with someone when their behavior threatens our national security, something you said Russia did. So I'm going to ask you one final time. How does their behavior threaten our national security or our democracy itself, as is often the claim? I don't understand that.
Okay, let's take Syria, for instance. Russia
giving up on Crimea.
Well, we talked about that a lot.
Okay.
I could talk about it all hour if you want. But take Syria. Russia intervened in Syria in September 2015 after the Obama administration failed to act and failed to punish Syria for crossing the red line. And that was a mistake. But when Russia intervened in September, it said it was intervening to fight ISIS. 1 week after its military and airstrikes, State Department said more than 90% of those airstrikes were against U.S.-backed forces in Syria, not against ISIS.
Okay,
So
because we back a series of Islamist rebel groups, some with ties to Al-Qaeda and ISIS, which we currently do, which, by the way, is insane, and because Russian bombing may have hurt some of those Islamists, that's a threat to our national security? If you could just, I know we don't have a ton of time left, but just connect the dots there for me if you would.
Sure, let me connect the dots for you. We are trying to stabilize Syria. We need to stabilize Syria. More than 400,000 people have been killed in Syria. Russia is not trying to stabilize Syria. Russia is propping up the Assad regime, which is fueling ISIS. ISIS was born out of the crisis in Syria, the fact that no one was supporting the moderates who were opposing Assad, and the Sunni population turned to ISIS. That's what created ISIS.
Boy,
ISIS is a convenient foe
for
Russia because Russia because ISIS is helping fight the battles that Russia wants fought. Do you think Russia cares that there was an ISIS-sponsored attack in Manchester?
Probably not. But exactly. I guess I kind of remember Syria when it was stable. And guess who ran it? Oh, the Assad family ran it.
That's correct.
And so it's hard to look me in the face and say supporting a bunch of people, some of whom may be good-hearted, some may be lunatics, is making a country more stable than what it was 8 years ago when it was run by a dictator who hated America and Israel, bad guy, but it was stable and now it's not. But so, call me stupid, but that seems like the fact.
So then you agree with President Obama that we should have not done anything in Syria. Because remember, the revolution that started in Syria, the U.S. didn't start that revolution.
Okay.
That was a revolution that started on its own, and it happened. And there were forces that went against Assad, and then eventually, when we didn't do anything, Russia went in. Now we have a destabilized country that helped create ISIS. We have a humanitarian disaster that's causing refugees to flee to Europe and to the U.S.
I'll tell you what.
We have more than 400,000 people killed.
I've lost any confidence I ever had in the ability of intellectuals in Washington to make the world stable. They've made it less stable, and now I'm really worried about their judgment. That's my bottom line.
So now you want Russia to do it?
No, I'm not saying that at all. I don't take any of this at face value anymore. I used to. David, thank you.
Tucker Carlson is locked on here. He has this guy in a corner. This guy is an avid Obama supporter, even though he admits during this that Obama did screw up with Syria, which is amazing that he even said that. But he can't answer the question that Tucker's asking. What threat does Russia right now have to our national security? Yeah, they might down the road. We all know that. But right now, we're dealing with terrorism. We're dealing with ISIS. So with that being said, why not use Russia as an ally, or at least trick them to think that we're not going to do anything about it, and still prepare against it for the future? There's no way any country, even our country, can fight terrorism, Russia, at the same time. It just can't happen. We don't have the resources, we don't have people, and we have too many liberals in this country that would do everything to make sure we tried to lose those wars. And in the long run, who's to say that we don't become friendlier with Russia and we can get along and they can be in that part of the world, we can even be in this part of the world, we can share interests globally, and you know, we still might have those tensions, but we don't need to start a war with them. That would not end well for Russia, obviously, and we would lose a lot of people too. And that's not what we want. We'd rather fight terrorism and then have the civilized countries, even though they have different forms of government. You know, we don't really believe what they believe because, you know, they're a little fascist when it comes to that. But, you know, why poke the bear when we can maybe use the bear to defeat ISIS or at least not get in our way? That's kind of the point here. But liberals don't really care about any of this stuff. They really don't. Their main goal is to defeat conservatism, to defeat anything that doesn't believe what they believe on the home front in this country. They don't really care about these other. Now, they claim they care because they use them to try to convince people to vote with them, to vote for them, to be on their side. They use all these other things as political pawns because their greatest enemy, as admitted by many of them, is the Republican conservative movement here in this country. Some more proof of that is they're willing to sacrifice innocent American lives and civilians by having open border policies, by not vetting immigrants coming into this country, by not really caring who comes in. They just want everyone here, and they want to use it an emotional political issue to get that done and defeat the Republican Party, because we're the ones standing in their way of total, complete power. I mean, we're their initial, first, and real threat, and they know that. And everybody that voted for Trump and all the Americans need to know that the liberals, they only use all this other stuff, all these other issues around the world, around the country, as a way to try to defeat their only person they care about defeating. And that's anybody who opposes what they believe. And right now, it's the conservatives and the Trump supporters and the Trump voters.
Is freedom and spreading democracy around the world. And the biggest foe of freedom and the spread of democracy is Russia. And we see that now in lots of different places where Russia is an actor, particularly in Eastern Europe, where it has designs on recreating a Russian empire, on recreating colony-type states that it had when it was the U.S.
Just for the hell of it, I'm going to ask the question one more time, because you didn't answer the question I asked. You basically said Russia's behavior offends our values as Americans, and I would agree with that completely. But that's not the criterion upon which we make war decisions. We go to war, we are enemies with someone when their behavior threatens our national security, something you said Russia did. So I'm going to ask you one final time. How does their behavior threaten our national security or our democracy itself, as is often the claim? I don't understand that.
Okay, let's take Syria, for instance. Russia
giving up on Crimea.
Russia, right, well, we talked about that a lot.
Okay.
I could talk about it all hour if you want. But take Syria. Russia intervened in Syria in September 2015 after the Obama administration failed to act and failed to punish Syria for crossing the red line. And that was a mistake. But when Russia intervened in September, it said it was intervening to fight ISIS. 1 week after its military has been threatening democracy for a long time.
Okay.
Look at the Cold War.
Wait, hold on. Before we jump back 26 years, let me just get to the discrete examples that you just listed. You say they're a threat to our way of life, to our democracy. I feel for the Ukrainians. I feel for the Crimeans. I feel for anybody whose nationalist hopes are thwarted. How is the annexation of Crimea or the conflict with Ukraine a direct threat to national security?
Because if Russia is allowed to annex Ukraine, it will annex another country next. It will annex one of the Baltic states.
Idaho?
It'll annex two of the Baltic states.
California? I mean, how will that affect American national security?
Do you not believe that there are countries like Russia who have... who desire to undermine democracy
all over
the world,
lots of them.
Particularly in Europe, and part of their strategy for doing that is undermining democratic efforts in countries like Ukraine, in the Baltic states.
I'm asking you simple questions. Just give me simple answers, if you would. How is Russia's expansionist tendencies, which are shared by a lot of countries around the world, lots of countries want to be bigger. This is the story of the world, of history. How does Russia's behavior in Eastern and Central Europe threaten America's critical national security interests or America's democracy?
Because one of the things that America has always stood for, that's
and
correct.
So it's hard to look me in the face and say supporting a bunch of people, some of whom may be good-hearted, some may be lunatics, is making a country more stable than what it was 8 years ago when it was run by a dictator who hated America and Israel, a bad guy, but it was stable and now it's not. Call me stupid, but that seems like the fact.
So then you agree with President Obama that we should have not done anything in Syria. Because remember, the revolution that started in Syria, the U.S. didn't start that revolution.
Okay.
That was a revolution that started on its own, and it happened. And there were forces that went against Assad, and then eventually, when we didn't do anything, Russia went in. Now we have a destabilized country that helped create ISIS. We have a humanitarian disaster that's causing refugees to flee to Europe and to the U.S.
I'll tell you
we
what,
have more than 400,000 people killed.
I've lost any confidence. Any confidence I ever had in the ability of intellectuals in Washington to make the world stable. They've made it less stable, and now I'm really worried about their judgment. That's my bottom
line.
So
now you want Russia to do it?
I'm not saying that at all. I don't take any of this at face value anymore. I used to. David, thank you.
Tucker Carlson's locked on here. He has this guy in a corner. This guy is an...
In airstrikes, State Department said more than 90% of those airstrikes were against U.S.-backed forces in Syria, not against ISIS.
Okay,
that's
so...
How.
So because we back a series of Islamist rebel groups, some with ties to Al-Qaeda and ISIS, which we currently do, which, by the way, is insane, and because Russian bombing may have hurt some of those Islamists, that's a threat to our national security? If you could just, I know we don't have a ton of time left, but just connect the dots there for me if you would.
Sure. Let me connect the dots for you. We are trying to stabilize Syria. We need to stabilize Syria. More than 400,000 people have been killed in Syria. Russia is not trying to stabilize Syria. Russia is propping up the Assad regime, which is fueling ISIS. ISIS was born out of the crisis in Syria, the fact that no one was supporting the moderates who were opposing Assad, and the Sunni population turned to ISIS. That's what created ISIS.
Boy.
ISIS is a convenient foe because ISIS is helping fight the battles that Russia wants fought. Do you think Russia cares that there was an ISIS-sponsored attack in Manchester?
Probably not. But
exactly.
I kind of remember Syria when it was stable, and guess who ran it? Oh, the Assad family ran it. Policy advisor, he once worked at the State Department, and I know that he's going to agree with me on this. Let me start with the obvious question. Which is a bigger threat to the U.S., ISIS or Russia?
Both are a huge threat.
Which is bigger?
Well, I think ISIS is a more immediate threat, absolutely. But Russia has a much stronger military. Russia can hurt us and hurt U.S. interests all over the world. So we have to worry about both.
So let me just, we don't have the graphic, because I'm just kind of going here with the facts as they are. We have on the one side ISIS, Islamic Terror, Al-Qaeda. Over the past 15 years, thousands of Americans have lost their lives, many thousands, to those forces. Russia has killed, let me just see, zero Americans. So it's really not even in the same universe, actually, the threat we face from Islamic Terror and the threat we face from Russia. One is theoretical, the other is real and present. So why are we not seeing that?
Well, first of all, Tucker, you can't evaluate the threat just based on how many American lives have been lost. Russia is a threat to democracy. It's a threat to our way of life. Look at what Russia has done in Ukraine. It annexed Crimea. It is in eastern Ukraine. It's killed a lot of people in Ukraine. Ukraine wanted to be part of the West. It wanted to be a democracy. It wanted to join Europe. It wanted to be our ally. Russia